Hey everybody, it's Matt Rendar. This is another Black Powder Battle Report, American Civil War. This is a fictitious battle of two Confederate brigades versus two brigades of Union. So the scenario I set up, I have a large hill in the middle of the battlefield, followed by one brigade of Confederate set up and one brigade of Union set up on both opposing sides. Some skirmish sharpshooters have deployed in the middle of the hill. The beginning of the game starts off with some command rolls and in line formation, in column, the Union start marching up the hill. Off to a bad start, the Confederates are a little slow coming onto the table. Two brigades from both of the Confederate and Union are in reserve. The first brigade of Confederates get online. They start to march up the hill to try to get the high ground first. But it appears that the Union are moving a little faster. So everybody's starting to spread into line to maximize firepower from their muskets. The sharpshooters are getting ready to shoot. Everybody's a little out of range so far. The cannon's still limbered. The reserves haven't showed up on both sides. The Union begin to crest the top of the hill in positions. The Confederates start to meet. Right out the gate, Union's getting disordered. Close volleys of musket fire start laying into each other. You can see some of the casualties. Sharpshooters, skirmishers start laying down and with their rifled muskets down into the Confederates coming up. So the brigade's cresting the hill. The cannon's still not on the bridge, racing to get to the top. So it's getting close. So they're starting to exchange volleys of fire on each other. Pretty intense. Cannon's still not unlimbered. The Union cannon's still not unlimbered. Still exchanging fire. Officers moving in. Sharpshooters accurately directing fire. Actually, in this brigade order for the entire brigade, it was a blunder, and the Confederates actually ran down the slope a little bit, backed up. Not good. They're gonna have to regain that ground, take more fire. So in the command and control, there are blunders that do happen in this confusion, and the units do random things occasionally. The Confederate reinforcements show up, so it's three battalions and a cannon, as well as Union. They start marching on the opposite sides of the field. The Union brigade colonel starts leading his men up the road near the church. Meanwhile, the Confederates that briefly fled down the hill return to go back up. The cannon's been disordered. That unit up front's been disordered. So the Confederates are just laying into them, trying to capture that hill. Very steep. Pretty awesome how it's starting to clash. Confederates continue moving up. Who is going to take the hill? Who is going to fold first? Confederate battalions taking some casualties. So very cool. Quickly trying to rush that cannon up there. More Union troops on the way. Well, one of the battalions has just fled. Just got routed by all the musket fire from the Confederates, fleeing off the table. One more breaks in that brigade, and that brigade's gonna rout as well. So the Union are trying to hold the top of the hill. Confederates have been slowed down. They come to the cotton, it means they've been disordered. They've been hit hard enough that they can't take orders. So same with this cannon. This cannon's having problems setting up. Sharpshooters earning their pay today, laying fire into that, trying to concentrate as much firepower, force them to rout. The Union new brigade starts to get in line and starts to make their way forward towards the enemy Confederates. Johnny Reb moving. absolutely love 20 millimeter miniatures. Very cool. I'd say about 95% of these miniatures are all parry. So the Confederates moving in a column, trying to get up, get close to form into line, and the Union is starting to prepare. The cannons have unlimbered, two of them, and they're all set up, ready to go. Another battalion starting to go just in case this flank collapses. Confederates taking lots of casualties, but are still fighting their way up the hill. Bloody game. Begin firing. And just too many casualties. This battalion of Confederates flees the table. Just concentrating that firepower into that. Meanwhile, on top of the hill, the Confederates and the Union troops exchange musket fire. Confederates starting to take casualties on the right flank. Those cannons are definitely a problem. Confederates gained ground, starting to push the beleaguered Union back down the hill. Even though they're getting shot up to pieces and close cannon fire, they're still fighting through. Confederates race into the graveyard of the church, taking up aggressive positions, firing, trying to see who breaks first. Maybe even a charge will come soon. The battle rages on. Union firing and continuing to fire. A lot of disorder going on. The Confederates charge into close combat. Fixed bayonets. Close battle. Confederates doing enough casualties, forcing the Union troops to rout, break, and flee. This was a devastating blow to the brigade on the left. And the entire Union brigade on the left begins to flee. So even though the Confederates are victorious on the hill, they are taking a lot of casualties. Pretty damaged. Hopefully they can muster up a bit. So they begin to reorganize, and of course as the Union have redirected a battalion and a cannon towards them. The Confederates are firing. The Union have support of two cannons above them on the hill. Sharpshooters. Confederates take too many casualties. The 1st Battalion. It's not good. The amount of firepower that they're dropping into them. The Confederates charge. Confederates they start to move down the hill. They try to fight the remaining Union brigade. Cannon waiting there. Confederates charge in close combat. Fixed bayonets. Screaming and yelling. Johnny Reb. Union take just a little too much casualties, fail their break test, and flee off the battlefield. Not looking good. It's kind of going tit for tat, back and forth. The Confederates taking a lot of wounds too, and they're rolling there. They actually had a tie, so they roll for theirs, and they stay. If there's a draw in close combat, you both have to take a break test. The Confederates firing into them, disordering the Union. Union cannon crews continue firing. The colonel yelling and screaming into their ears. Both units getting disordered. Negatives to the hits. the remnants of the Confederate brigade up there going. They have to take morale tech. Oh, brutal failure. 3. No good. That is going to flee off the battlefield. The first brigade of Confederates have taken too many casualties. The remnants are going in. It's looking pretty dismal for both sides. It can go either way. Those are Confederates running in the back. All alone, a Confederate cannon crew firing. Another cannon crew on top of the hill over there. Confederates go in. Horrible morale. At close range, they're shot to pieces by cannons. Cannon battery. And they flee. This is the remnants of the last brigade of Confederates. They were victorious on the hill, and now they've been decimated. Now it's down to 2 brigades. Barely alive. Shot to pieces. Oh, 6 for morale. They're staying. High is good, low is very bad. The remnants of the Confederates on the hill are leaving, fleeing the battlefield. Not looking good. Confederates shooting cannon, long range. What's gonna happen? That Union battalion's taking so many casualties. Rolling with 6, but with the negatives. It's gonna be a break. No good. The Union battalion begins to flee the battlefield. And that is the end. Too much for that brigade to take. The brigade collapses and flees off, becoming a Confederate victory. What a great game. A lot of fun. Big fan of Black Powder. It's a quick way. I think this game took maybe like 2.5 hours. Move all these models around. That concludes. Thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Many more Black Powder battle reports coming to the channel. Like and subscribe.